This life is beautiful.
Listen, I want you to know that I take you as my younger sister and I won't lead you into troubles. I'm doing all of this to make you happy. Okay?
Okay. Thank you.
Good, so try it. Stop dulling me. Try it.
Thank you. But please, I'll be going to see Dr. Chris. I need an advice on something. You know, he was in charge of my case when I lost the baby.
But do you know the way to the hospital?
Yes.
Okay. Okay then. I kept 2,000 naira in the second drawer. So you can just use the money for your taxi.
But please, pick a taxi and come back home once there's any problem.
Okay? Thank you. Thank you.
Okay, so you try now. Let's see. Remember, you can try this shoe. This shoe goes on that dress. You like it? So just try, right?
Okay.
I'll be right back. Let me just... okay, come. Try it. I'm coming.
Okay.
Good morning, nurse.
Good morning. How may I help you?
I'm here to see Dr. Chris.
Oh, I'm sorry. Dr. Chris just stepped out a few minutes ago.
Oh, I see. When is he coming in for work?
I don't know. He has just done a night shift and usually after a night, I don't know when he will resume again.
Okay. When he comes back, tell him that Ngozi came to see him.
Okay. All right.
Thank you.
You're welcome.
Good morning, nurse. How is work?
Work is fine. Dr. Chris is not on duty now.
Really?
Yes, he did night and usually won't resume until the next day.
I know.
Your sister that was treated here a few days ago also came in. She just left.
Huh?
Yes, did she meet her again?
No. Did she meet Chris?
No.
Thank you. Thank you very much.
Don't you understand? Adam's checkbooks. His powerhouse.
And so?
We will drain his account and run away.
And how do you think that's possible without his signature, Mildred?
Listen, we'll forge his signature. You take the check, Cliff, and go to the bank and cash it. The bank knows you because you're the only one that withdraws and lodging money. Then, you call the bank manager, tell him that Adam is in trouble. In case the NDLA gets nosy, he will believe you. After all, everyone knows about Adam's arrest.
Look, Mildred, we're already putting things in motion to get him out.
But I told you to do everything to frustrate his coming out from there.
What if I don't succeed and Razor goes ahead to do it? What do you think Adams will do to us if he comes out?
You know what? You're a jellyfish.
Millie.
Oh! Why are you so afraid of Adams? Can't you be a man for once? As it is, if Adams comes out, I am a dead person. So no going back for me. I warn you. If you don't come with me, you are my enemy. And I will destroy you along with Adams.
Millie.
Final.
Thank you. It's not that I am afraid.
I don't care whether you're with me or not. I am going now to help destroy Adams and anyone around him. Mama, it is your choice to be wherever you want to be. Why do you drag your feet? Why?
I'm not dragging, Millie. I'm not dragging my feet. It's just that we need to be more careful, that's all.
No. I'll tell you what. You're more interested in your comfort zone. Being around him, making money, without even caring if I'm dying or not. When you told him I was your sister, instead of being bold to tell him I am your girlfriend. Mama, under the cover that I am your sister, you've made so much money. Why I die in his hands? He treats me brutally and locks me up here like an animal. He don't even care. For the past 2 years, he has not seen my nakedness and he forbids me from having fun. Why are you busy making your money? Why won't you drag your feet? Well, let me tell you something. I am sick and tired of all of you. And I want out. Not just out. I want my vengeance. I am a moving train. And anyone, including you, that stands on my way will be crushed.
What you want to do? You know I'm with you all the way.
Fine. You will drain his account. In that way, he would be incapacitated to fight back or come after us. He won't even have money to start business again. While he's struggling to start up his business, we are far away.
I understand that, but if I may ask, how do you intend to drain his account?
Well, you know the man that forged his signature, don't you? Get him to forge his signature and a letter detailing the bank manager to transfer all the money to our joint account. Simple.
You have this all planned out, Millie. Okay.
You're
I'll
here.
Do it.
You're here.
I'm with
Thank you.
You should have told me you were going to see Ahmed. I'd have told you not to bother. It's a hard nut to crack.
Our other option would be that boy, Tamino. He must not testify.
You must ensure he does not testify. I don't care what you do. I don't care how you do it, but it must not appear in court. If it does not, it will weaken their hold against me. And then I can tell my lawyer to appear while I'm being held here. And don't let me go.
Mama, we go for the ball.
We'll go for the boy, boss.
Now, I need you guys to be very careful. Those guys have their eyes wide open. And they'll do everything to protect their star witness. Okay? Now go.
I want results.
All right, sir.
Thank you.
You will find the other
sister, when did you come?
Around 4.
You should have told me you were coming so that I'll wait up for you. Shade, this is my elder sister, Ngozi's mom. Sister, this is my friend Shade.
Welcome, sister.
How are you?
I'm fine, ma. If you would like to take my leave while you attend to her,
no problem.
We'll see later now.
We'll see later.
Take care, babe.
How was your journey, ma?
I thank God.
And how is work? Work is fine. You didn't tell me you were coming. What if I traveled out of town?
I only made up my mind last night. And since we had discussed before and you never mentioned anything about traveling, I assumed you would be around.
Anyway, so what happened to Ngozi? I sent her back to Lagos. Obviously, she didn't board the vehicle.
But what happened? Because you never said anything to me about sending her back to Lagos. And if it was an agreement between the two of you that she goes back to Lagos, why would she not board the vehicle?
I don't know why she did not board.
So how then did you know that she did not board?
Because I'm just coming from the hospital, from seeing my fiance. And I was told Ngozi was there today to see him.
She went to see him. Why?
I don't know.
Okay, so we'll have to wait for your fiance to come and he will tell us whether he saw her or not.
My fiance no longer stays here. We had a misunderstanding. Would you like to have a bath or food first?
None of the two. I want to see your fiance so that he can tell me exactly what has happened to Ngozi.
Fine.
Hey!
Good afternoon, doctor.
Right.
Excuse me, doctor. Your fiance came to look for you.
Oh, really?
Another lady also came. Her name is Ngozi.
Ngozi? When did she come? Where is she?
I don't know. But she came in the morning as soon as you left. Shortly after, your fiance came in.
Did Ngozi drop any note as far where she might be or how I can reach her?
No, doctor. She didn't.
If Ngozi comes again, please let me know.
Sister, why don't you eat something? Ever since you came, you have not left this sitting position.
How can I eat when my daughter is somewhere they are missing? Who knows where she is? Have you realized that if anything happens to that girl, I am finished? My husband will kill me. How come you couldn't take care of my own daughter?
Ngozi, Ngozi, Ngozi. Can't I hear something else in this house? This is the same Ngozi that came in here and ruined my relationship with my fiance. If it wasn't for her, my fiance would still be here by now.
Hey! The leopard has finally shown its claws. So that is it. You sent her out of your house because of your fiance?
Why shouldn't I? It was when she started throwing herself at him that he started neglecting me. Why shouldn't I ask her out of my house?
You're not Ngozi. My Ngozi is not like that. Ngozi is a properly brought up girl and very decent.
If she was a saint, how did she get herself pregnant? If not that she's loose.
Ngozi was a virgin until she was raped. The rape got her pregnant. What attracted your fiance to her was her proper upbringing and manners. Ife, tell me, do you now know how to cook? Do you now know how to take care of your own house? Are you now selfless and care about other people? Those are the qualities Ngozi has that you don't. Men are not blind, you know.
Then you people should leave me alone and let me be! Ha!
Hey!
Yes. This is the signature.
Okay.
I want you to duplicate that on this checkbook and this letter.
I can't even tell the difference. Oh my god. This is unbelievable. Wow.
They are all good.
For you, but more for me, not the experts. Where do you want it?
I want you to duplicate that on this checkbook and this letter.
Okay.
That is it. Yes?
Thank you very much.
Thank you.
It's late today. First thing in the morning, we'll go to the bank and cash it before you go out with Razor, okay?
That man is good.
The guy is cute.
should be Boboyo.
Let me get it.
Yes.
Uh-huh. Where are the beautiful ones?
Hi.
We are ready and we've been waiting for you.
You girls are beautiful.
Thank you. You can say that again.
Thank you.
Where is Ngozi?
She's in the room.
I'll
get her the way.
Come on.
So you two are also taken in by Ngozi's charm?
How come, oh my dear? This girl is beautiful. Even the blind can see that. See, Salvatore would love her. Come on, let's go, Jari. Go and finish up and let's go, Daddy.
Sweetheart, we are good to go.
You know I don't do this, but I'm doing it because of you. Is it safe for me?
It is safe for you. If I am safe, you are also safe, okay? I'm not going to do anything that will let you get into trouble. Let's go. One more thing. Just all done. Okay. Let me see. Yes, suits your face. Let me see. Yes. Do you like it? Come on, let's go. You're beautiful. Let's go.
Thank you.
Turn around. Wow, let's go. The whiteys are in trouble tonight. Let's go. Okay.
Go. Wow. She's beautiful, isn't she? Ngozi, how are you?
I'm fine, thank you.
Alright, if you say so, hop in the car and let's go.
Oh yeah, sure. Let's go.
Good evening, Daddy.
Adeswa. Any news of Ngozi? Is she in Port Harcourt?
No, I haven't seen her yet. You know, I just arrived. Give me some time to look for her.
But it is only your sister that she knows in Port Harcourt. Has she seen her?
No, she has not.
That means she's not in Port Harcourt. So start coming back.
See, you know I just arrived. Give me some time to look around for her. Eh? You know she has friends all over the place. So I just have to go around one of them and we can't tell. Maybe she would have called one of them by phone and tell them where she is.
It's okay.
I'm sorry for the way I spoke to you earlier this evening. Please, I want you to understand my predicament. My husband does not know that I sent Ngozi here. I'm in enough trouble as it is. Added with this missing thing, it's just too much. He will simply kill me. Please, Efe, I want you to understand my position and forgive my outburst. And I'm also very sorry for your missing friends. See, all I want is for us to sit down and plan on how to solve this whole problem.
Okay. Apology accepted. I'm also sorry about the way I reacted. Knowing what it means to you to have come down here.
Okay.
Why don't you go back to bed? In the morning, we'll go to the hospital and look for her there. Maybe she has come back to look for Chris.
Okay. Thank you, Ife. Good night.
Good night, ma.
Keeping you waiting.
Could that be the restroom?
Thank you.
This life is beautiful.